Hello, hockey fans, and welcome back to another video. Scoring points is one of, if not the most fundamental requirement in hockey. Whether it's racking up goals or notching assists, putting the puck in the back of the net is the real bread and butter of the sport. With the talent on display in the National Hockey League, and with several trophies up for grabs for the top point getters, it isn't uncommon to see players put up multiple points in a game. Though most multi-point nights will see a player score 2, 3, or even 4 points, there have been a select few that have managed to score a whopping 8 different points in a single game. In fact, there are only 10 players in the entire history of the league that have accomplished such a feat, including some of the best players to have ever played the game, like Wayne Gretzky, Paul Coffey, Mario Lemieux, and Peter Stastny. However, one of the most surprising members of this exclusive club is this guy. This is the story of Sam Gagner, the unlikeliest 8-point player in NHL history. In order to tell this tale, allow me to take you back to February 2nd, 2012. Sam Gagner, a 22-year-old forward and former 6th overall draft pick by the Edmonton Oilers in 2007, was getting ready to take to the ice of Rexall Place, as Edmonton hosted the Chicago Blackhawks for a game of Thursday night hockey. At the time, the Oilers had earned the unflattering reputation as a basement dweller in the league, having finished last place in the NHL standings in both of the past 2 seasons. On the other side of the ice, their opponent was heralded as one of the league's elite sides, less than 2 years removed from a Stanley Cup championship, and on their way to another pair of cup wins in the following 3 years. In the midst of this continued mediocrity, Gagner had started to make a name for himself in oil country. The Canadian forward had scored 5 goals and 22 points so far during the 11-12 season, and had finished each of his previous 4 NHL years with at least 41 points. That said, he wasn't a superstar by any stretch, and that makes what happens next all the more incredible. 21 minutes into the contest, the two teams were practically reading from the script. The Blackhawks were up 2-0, thanks to a first period goal from Jamal Mayers and a Patrick Sharp tally just 40 seconds into the second. Having seen this kind of result many times over the past few years, and with the threat of things getting much worse, Gagner decided that enough was enough. It all started at 2:22 of the second period, when Gagner notched the lone assist on Taylor Hall's 18th goal of the season to cut Chicago's lead in half. Over the next 10 minutes, Gagner would score his 6th goal of the season and assist Ryan Whitney in getting his first of the year on the power play to take his point total to 3 and give the Oilers a 3-2 lead. With a shorty by Patrick Sharp late in the second, the game would be tied 3-3 as the puck dropped for the final stanza of play. It was then that Gagner decided to roll his sleeves up and really get to work. Almost 4 minutes into the third period, Gagner had already picked up points 4 and 5, as he scored his 2nd goal of the game at 1:54 and assisted on a Cam Barker tally at 3:43. Chicago's Dave Boland would cut the lead to just 1 at 5:57, but after that, it was all Gagner. Point number 6 came at 6:25 when Gagner completed his hat-trick. Number 7 came with his 4th goal of the night at 14:31, and his 8th and final point would come on an assist of Jordan Eberle's 20th goal of the year. As the final buzzer sounded and the home crowd stood up from their seats and chanted Gagner's name, the former first-round pick had just made history in the modern NHL. In just 35 minutes of overall game time and 17 minutes and 28 seconds of total ice time, Gagner had scored 4 goals on 6 shots and had assisted on 4 others. The Oilers would win the game 8-4, and Gagner would be the first player in more than 23 years to score 8 points in a single NHL game. The last player to do so? None other than Mario Lemieux back on April 25th, 1989. Not only that, but Gagner was the first player to score 8 points against a team with an above 500 record since Wayne Gretzky did so on January 4th, 1984, also with the Oilers. And he was the first to do so while playing for an under 500 team since Peter and Anton Stastny did so in the same game for the Quebec Nordiques on February 22nd, 1981. The 80s were a crazy time for everyone. So, what happened to Gagner following this milestone night? Did he use this monster game to finally establish himself as a top player in the league and live up to the hype that comes with being a sixth overall pick? Well, in the years following his 8-point performance, Gagner has been on quite the journey around the league. The Canadian forward spent another 2 seasons in Edmonton, amassing 75 points in 115 games, before being traded to the Arizona Coyotes, where he spent a single season and scored 41 points in 81 games, before being traded again to the Philadelphia Flyers, where he spent another year, as well as a brief stint in the AHL, and scored just 16 points in 53 games. As an unrestricted free agent, he then signed a 1-year deal with the Columbus Blue Jackets, had the best season of his career so far with a 50-point campaign, before signing a 3-year contract with the Vancouver Canucks. The former first-round pick played a year with the Canucks, then spent much of the next year in the AHL on loan to the Toronto Marlies, before coming around full circle as he was traded back to Edmonton on February 16th, 2019. Who says you can't go home, folks? In the 8 years following that historic night, Gagner has played for 5 different teams, and played for 1 team on 2 separate occasions. Talk about raking in those air miles! At the time of this recording, Gagner is still a member of the Oilers roster for the current 1920 season, and has scored 7 points in 15 games, so he continues to produce at roughly a point every other game pace, just like he has done for most of his 13-year NHL career. At just 30 years of age, and with 453 points in 817 games, he hasn't quite reached the pedigree that comes with being drafted so high. But give credit where credit is due, Gagner has managed to forge a good reputation for himself as a serviceable NHL player who can provide secondary scoring and a veteran presence to a roster. And provided things go well, he has a number of years left to keep producing points, maybe reach the 1,000 game plateau, and prove that his selection 6th overall was the right choice after all. Also, let's not forget that the Oilers have had their fair share of lottery picks over the last decade, so Gagner has had some pretty tough competition to be compared with, like Taylor Hall, Connor McDavid, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, or Neil Yakupov, wait a minute, or Magnus Pajarvi, or Jesse Puljujärvi. Okay, I really need to stop this joke now, don't I? What I'm trying to say is, Edmonton certainly could have done a lot worse. I mean, they liked Gagner so much, they even brought him back 6 years later. That's something, right? Though he is an unlikely candidate to have reached such a milestone, given his track record, Sam Gagner found his own unique way to get his name into the hockey history books. Unless he finds a way to post a 9 or even 10 point game in the following seasons, nothing he has done in his career so far, or will do in the years to come, will ever quite compare to that night in February 2012. And with that, I'm going to end today's video. What do you guys think about Sam Gagner's 8 point game? Do you think we will ever see something like it again? Let me know in the comments below, I would love to hear what you guys think. But thank you very much for watching, guys, I hope you have enjoyed. Please feel free to like, subscribe, share, or watch some of my other videos. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye! A big thank you to Chris Gadsby, Connor B, Martin Tolness, Max Artis, Nat Marlowe, and Paul Malia, as well as a huge thank you to The Legacy for helping support this video via Patreon. If you too want to help support the channel a little bit further and get a shout out at the end of every future video, make sure you head over to patreon.com/oddmanrush and become a patron today.